Hi, WisconsinGarden.net, Lynn again. Once you have harvested your crops, then you have to do something with them. You can eat as many as your body will take, but if you're lucky, you're going to have more than you can eat fresh. So you need to preserve it, just like you needed to preserve your strawberries. With fruit, it's pretty easy because you can just toss that into the freezer, or you can dry it, and you don't really have to prepare it too much in advance. But vegetables are different. You have to blanch them if you're going to freeze them. Blanching means you have to put them in hot water for just a really short time to stop the maturation process. Then you want to stop the cooking by immersing them in ice very quickly, and then you can finally freeze them. And thanks to the Farmer's Daughter WordPress blog, that I checked on my recipe this morning, I was right, and thanks to her, now I know I'm right. So what I've done is I've taken my peas, I snipped the ends off, I pulled the strings off, I saved them, I'm going to put them on my compost pile. Now I'm going to take these, I already have my water boiling. I am lucky enough to have a basket in there that I can just lift them out, but with them boiling, let me turn it back up here, I want them to boil for 1 minute to stop the maturation process. So I'm setting my timer for 1 minute, and while those are cooking for your 1 minute, you want to make sure that you have your water bath ready. So I've got cold water here. I'm going to add my ice. Have this ready ahead of time, or just run them under cold water as fast as you can. So that's ready now for when the timer goes off. And then once that's done, once they're immersed, they'll also keep their bright green color. If you let them go too long, they're not going to be pretty. They'll be a darker green. They won't be as appetizing. So as these cook, I'm just going to make sure they're all under there, getting their full minute in the boiling hot water. But you can see how beautifully green they are. You can do this with peas and beans. There we go. Be careful, you're dealing with hot water here. This strainer is nice, but you can just as well use a slotted spoon, fish them out. Now I'm just going to take the whole thing and right into the ice they go. Like I said, you want to get them as cold as possible, as fast as possible. That stops the cooking. They'll still, at this point, they're still crisp. Okay, and then just try them. Need to go just a little bit longer, a little more chili. These would be called parboiled, I guess.
Called what?
Parboiled. It's partly boiled, partly cooked. And from here, I'm going to take them over to a towel that I already have laid out. And I'm going to let them drain off so they're not in a big chunk when I freeze them. They'll all be separate so I can use just what I want. Okay, those feel pretty good. Over to my towel. Lay them out. You can see they're still bright and pretty and green. Oops, one for the dogs. Richard, I hear you munching.
Mmm, those are really good. Sweet.
And crunchy.
Mm-hmm. Can you hear me crunch?
I hear you crunch. Okay, once they're dry, into the plastic bag they go. Mark it with what they are and the date you made them. Happy crunching. Bye.